Morning, children. See, in the last class we have discussed about the other mode of nutrition. Okay, so first half of the lesson we learnt about the autotrophic mode, and in the second half of the lesson we are going to discuss about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In that, I told you about the parasitic plant like cascuta or amarbal. Okay, so how it grows, how it sucks. Okay, that all I told. So wherever it is growing, no, it is growing on the other body part. That means other trees or plants, like that it is growing and sucking the food from the plant body. So that where it is growing, no, that part we will call it as a, that plant we will call it as a host body. So from the host body it derives the food or it sucks the food and it is getting the ready-made food from that plant. Okay, so it need not to prepare or synthesize because it is not having the chlorophyll, lack of chlorophyll. That's why it is depending on the host body and sucking the food and residing there only. Okay, so this type of plants we'll call them as the parasites. Parasites means they are depending on the others for the food, other plants or organism for the food. Okay, so this is first mode. Parasitic mode is the first heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Today we are going to discuss about the other heterotrophic mode, the second type of the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so coming to the heterotrophic mode, as you know already, these are not having the chlorophyll, that's why they are depending on others. So few plants are there. See, this amarbal or the cascuta, it is going and residing on the other plant body. Okay, there it is sucking. But few plants are there, they are trapping the insects. They are eating the insects and digesting them. Okay, so what do you call them as? They are the insectivorous plants. What we will call? They are insectivorous plants. Okay, see, they don't have, these are green in color or any other color maybe. They can synthesize the food, okay, but due to lack of some nutrients in their body, or since they are not getting that type of nutrient in that soil where they are growing, okay. So to compensate that lack, okay, they need some nutrients which is not available to them. That is the reason they are eating the insects. They are trapping the insect. They are waiting for the insects to come and sit on them and they are engulfing them. Okay, these plants, some plants, not all the plants, some plants due to lack of some nutrients, okay, where they are residing, no, in that place, they are not getting all the nutrients, especially the nitrogen. What they are lacking? The nitrogen they are lacking. Okay, so that they want, they are not getting in that particular soil. That's why they trap the insects and they are digesting them. So this is the insectivorous plant, we will call them. Okay, so these insectivorous plants, they, since they are eating the insects, we are calling them as a heterotrophic mode. They comes under heterotrophic mode. Okay, they are not preparing, they are preparing the food, but since they are depending on other, okay, others they are depending means we'll call them as heterotrophic mode. So other mode of nutrition means heterotrophic mode under, this is the second category. Okay, now coming to this insectivorous plant, the example is the picture plant. Here I showed this. Okay, see the plant, maybe the ordinary plant, how others plant will be, they are not like that only it will be. See, I'll show you the picture. See, the plant will be like this. Especially this will be growing in a forest area, thick forest area. The plant will be in this way. Okay, it is having a sack like or a picture like. Okay, a bag like structure. It is there, no? That is what I have written here. Okay, mainly this part is used to trap the insects here. That's why I wrote here. The plant will be normal like that only. Here it is the leaf part. The leaf part of a plant is modified in this way. Okay, so the best example for insectivorous plant is pitcher plant. Pitcher means it is like a jug. See the shape like this, it's like a jug like. Okay, which we'll use for drinking water, no? Like that jug like structure it is. Okay, so the name is given pitcher plant. So it is a modified part of a leaf. Which part is modified here in a plant body? The leaf part is modified here and it became a picture like structure. Okay, so like this structure, how it uses? See, it is a sac like structure, I told. So see, like a bag like structure, here there is a hole is there and it is having a separate lid also. See, this is the lid. Okay, see, this is the apex part or opening part. Okay, so with this apex the lid is attached to here. Okay, this lid can be able to open and close. Okay, like that lid is made. Okay, see the modified leaf part it is, and it is having a apex. Apex means front part, tip part. Okay, so that apex are it is having the lid part. It is attached to the lid and that lid is able to open and close. Got it? So the it is near to the mouth of a pit. So it is a pit or it is a sac where there is a groove is there. Inside something can go and hide. Okay. So like that structure it is having. So this we will call it as a pit here. Okay. Pit means if we go once inside, we will fall into it. Okay. Like that pit like structure it is having. Okay. Then when insect lands on the lid, see, suppose one insect want to sit here. Okay, so on the lid anywhere it want to sit. Okay, or here it want to sit. So suppose it want to sit here. Here there is a slimy structure. Okay, a jelly like thing is there. Okay, which is very slippery. When the insect lands here, suddenly it falls inside the pit. Okay, so when it falls inside, this lid will be closing. Okay, so when the lid closes again, that insect can't come out again. Why? Because here it is very slippery. Okay, this apex part is there, no? It is somewhat jelly like substance is placed upon that, so that insect is, when it want to sit, no, it slips down. Okay, and inside each here in the inside the pit, the all the many hairs are present. Small tiny hair like structures are present. They are facing downwards. See, when insect lands on the lid, it closes gets entangled into the hairs. Okay, it is closing the lid. Entangled means it is jumbled there. Okay, between the hairs it is stuck there. Okay, so it cannot come out again. Like that it is entangled there, because and it, these hairs also facing downwards like this. And it is slippery also, these hairs are facing downwards, or it is entangled here only, and then it will be pulled and down it is thrown here. Okay, when once the insect is trapped here, what happens? The lid will be closing and it starts to produce the digestive juices. Okay, so when it started digestive juices to release from its body, the insect will be fully smashed there and melted, and it will be digested. So what it want, the nitrogenous thing or other vitamins or whatever the insect is having, no, from that all the things this plant will suck. Okay, then it will be circulated to the plant body. So in this way the insectivorous plant is there that will be eating the insect, and it is digesting the food there to because of lack of some nutrients in its body. Okay, especially the nitrogen is lack in this body. Okay, so the insect eating plants we will call it as insectivorous plants. What these are? The insect trapping they are. Okay, since they are eating insects, we will call them as insectivorous plants. Okay, so this is another mode of nutrition. Insectivorous plants, These are also called as parasites only. They are depending upon the others for the food. Okay. Then, coming to the next mode, that is the heterotrophic mode. Another mode of nutrition under that, the saprotrophs. Okay. So saprotrophs, maybe you heard. Okay, so these saprotrophs means some bushy moss like structure. They are not so much grown up plant like other plants are there, no, like that. These plants are not having the branches, stem part, fruit part, leaf part, that is not visible in these plants. Since these are also coming under the heterotrophic, they are also depending on others for the food. Okay, so these are also not having the chlorophyll, that's why they are depending on other. So you may be seen that the fungi, maybe you observed or seen, you may be heard about fungi. Okay, see, fungi are nothing but the group of organisms. They are growing on the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so where they are growing, they are observing the food from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so fungi means the best example is the mushroom. Okay, so wherever the like this structure, you can observe wherever marshy area, the logs of wood they have placed in one place, and many days from few things are kept aside for many days. Their shaded area, dark area. So in that places, wherever little bit wet, cool places there, no, there these fungi will develop. Okay, best example is mushroom. About fungi means mushroom. Okay, so you may be seeing these mushrooms. Okay, they may be round or spherical or like a umbrella also. Okay, somewhat pale colored, white also, white and gray it is mixed. So like that mushrooms we had seen, no, those are nothing but the fungi. Okay, so they are fluffy umbrella like patches which are growing on the soil bed, and especially where the there will be the rotting things are there. Okay, so rotten things on that they will develop. Where they will grow on the rotten things. Okay, so this fungi is we will call them as a saprotroph. Why? Because these organisms, they are coming under the mode of nutrition where they will take the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. So we will call them as saprotrophic organisms. Okay, so the water saprotrophs means, I'll write it here. Organisms take in nutrients from dead decaying matter. Dead and decaying matter. Okay. So such organisms we call it as saprotrophs. Okay. So the organisms which take in nutrients, okay, so they are taking the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter, so those we will call it as a saprotrophs, and their mode of nutrition is the saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so in that way we can observe these saprotrophs in our houses also. where we can observe there is an activity they given, activity 1.2, in that they have, we can grow these saprotrophs in our house only, and we can see under the microscope because they are very minute in structure. See, this to grow the saprotrophs, you have to collect a slice of bread, okay, place it in a plate, okay, so a slice of bread, okay, so in that sprinkle little water, okay, some of the water you have to sprinkle it, so it should not be dry, okay, it should be wet. To see, I told you, know already they are growing always in the wet, shady, marshy area, rottening things on it is growing, okay, so the bread should get the they should start to rotten, that time this fungi are growing, okay. So take a bowl or plate, and that place the bread piece, okay. So you are placing the bread on your plate and sprinkling some water, okay, spraying some water on it, keep it aside for few days. You see that after 2-3 days again you sprinkle some water. So within a week you can see there will be a cottony moss will be appearing on the, okay, brown colored or yellow colored, some moss will be appearing, okay. So they are nothing but a dust like powdery appearance, you'll get it. So that is nothing but the fungi what it is grown. Okay, if you see like that visibly, you cannot see properly them because they are like a bushy and it is crowded. Alone, like a plant, you cannot see that one. So if you see under the microscope, how it will be? It is having a base like this, hyphae we will call it, and it is having a plant body like this, and at the tip there will be a globe. Okay, so lobe-like structure. This lobe part we'll call it as the sporangia. Okay, so this sporangia, it is having the spores in it. Got it? This is the plant body. If you observe the fungi which is grown on the bread piece, it will be like this. Okay, it is called as, the base will be called as hyphae. Okay, so upon this hyphae the plant will be growing in this, okay, in this way. Only the stem part like that, one stalk like structure it will be there, and a lobe. Okay, so this grows within few days, within a week only this grows. After that it is bearing a sporangia in it. So after few days when it is getting all the nutrients, good the climatic conditions, all it is getting means it will grow and form the sporangia. In that spores will be forming. Okay, so after few days that spores, they will burst open. Okay, if it is opened like this, here spores are coming out. Okay, spores will burst open and again they are forming a new plant body. Okay, so in this way this spores will be produced in that, and that bread will be forming one more fungi family. Okay, one more fungi plant it will be forming. Okay, in this way this plants, these we will call it as a saprotrophs. Wherever the marshy area or this cool area is there, no, so which the things we kept aside for many longer days, okay, without touching them, there also they are growing. Okay, so these are growing other than this one, means the in our houses only, means on the pickles, on the leather and on the clothes. Okay, leather parts wherever it is there, on the pickles, some food items if you kept aside for many days, on that it will develop. Okay, so in this way this fungi are growing. Best example, the mushroom you can give as a saprotroph. Okay. Next, coming to the other part is the symbiotic mode. Okay, so what is that symbiotic mode? I'll tell you. Last part, heterotrophic mode, among that Third one, saprotrophs we studied. This is the third part. Fourth part, as a heterotrophic mode, symbiotic. Symbiotic means symbiosis. It is nothing but living together. Together. Symbiosis means living together. Why they are living together means because both of them are benefited by it. Okay, so that we will call it as symbiosis. Okay, some organisms live together and share, they are sharing both shelter and nutrients. Shelter and nutrients. They are sharing. Okay, so two organisms live together. They share shelter and nutrients both. This relationship we will call it as symbiosis. Understand? So, some organisms, see you can write down, if you want you write down, some organisms live together and share shelter and nutrients, those we will call it as the symbiosis. Okay, so best example for which two types of organisms are living together, so best example it is given as the fungi. Okay, fungi live inside the root of the plants. Where it is living? In the roots of the plant. So, this fungi, what it does, the plant provide nutrient to the fungi. Root of plants. So, plants are providing food, nutrients it is giving. Okay, so the example for symbiotic organisms means the fungi, where it is living, root of plants. Okay, so here plant and fungi both are mutually benefited. How they are benefited? Plant is giving the nutrients to the fungi because fungi cannot prepare the food, and fungi in turn it is giving the water and nutrients. It is giving water and also nutrients. Understand? Fungi also giving some of the nutrients because it is always growing on the rotten things, and rotten things are nothing but the manure. That things will be rottening because of the presence of fungi only. That will, this fungi, what they will do? They will suck the juice from the rotten things and it will be secreted out like a raw material, like a manure to the plants. Where these fungi are living, no, they were getting the manure for the plants. Okay, so this is giving a food which is manure to the plant, and these plants are preparing the food and nutrients will be sucked by the fungi. So in this way both are benefited here. Okay, so one more example, like lichens. Second example, lichens. So lichens, a chlorophyll containing partner, which is an alga and a fungus. So lichens means alga and fungus. Okay, so alga can prepare the food. You know, alga we studied under autotrophic mode. Okay, they are green in color, other color alga also, they can prepare the food. So in them photosynthesis is occurring. So they are preparing the food and giving to fungus. Wherever fungi are living, they are giving the good manure to the plant, to the alga. So they prepare the food to the fungus, and the minerals are given to the plant, by fungus. So in this way both are benefited. Lichens are nothing but the combination of alga and fungus. Okay, so alga is preparing the food and developing by itself. Okay, so for that it is helping. Fungus is making the things to rotten. No, that rotteny things are the good nutrients, good manure to the plant. Okay, so that alga will suck those nutrients and developing, and from in other ways the fungus is getting the food by alga. Okay, so in that way both are benefited. Here fungus is getting the place by alga. Both are getting the shelter also, food also, by living together. This relationship only we will call it as a symbiotic method. Okay, so this is one example I gave. Now last topic, how nutrients are replenished in the soil. Okay, how the nutrients always the plants are getting in the soil. Okay, again and again it is replenished. Again and again the soil should rotate this nutrients. Okay, once this all plants grown, they sucked all the nutrients, then what about the other plants which are growing now? Okay, so it should replenish, means it should recycle them. Okay, how they are getting always like that plants? Okay, see, you had seen that, you observed, or if you ask any farmers, you know, you ask them how the plants will grow in a healthy way. Okay, so they want some minerals, no? How they will get it? They will answer, we are providing the manure, we are providing them the good fertilizers. So manure, or this is also called as fertilizer. Okay, so manure or fertilizer we will provide for the plants along with the water. That also makes plant to grow in a healthy way. Okay, so this fertilizers and manures, they contain much of nutrients. Okay, what type of nutrients they contain? See, those nutrients are very much required for the plant body. Okay, so these manure, they have the nutrients. What of type of nutrients they have? They have nitrogen, okay, potassium, and phosphorus. So these are the nutrients that fertilizers have. Okay, fertilizers have some of the nutrients which the farmers are giving to the field, okay, to grow in a healthy way. Plants all need this nutrients. Okay, so they are adding some fertilizers or manure to it. In that fertilizers, mainly the nutrients like this nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus, these are all it is bearing. That is very much needed for the plant's growth. Okay, so these plants, these nutrients will give much strength to the plant body and they will grow. Okay, so usually the plants absorb a lot of nitrogen from the soil only. Okay, so where some they need lot of amount of nitrogen from the soil. If it is lack, means what they will do? They will add this one. Okay, fertilizer they will add. Okay, sometimes the nature only it is giving the nitrogen in the soil. How it is? Already I told you, in the nature nitrogen is present in a gaseous form. Okay, so that gaseous form will be converted into the usable form by some bacteria. So that bacteria we will call it as a rhizobium bacteria. The bacteria name is rhizobium bacteria. Okay, so where it resides? In some places it resides in the place in the plants where there is a leguminous plants. Okay, plants like example gram, peas, mung, beans. See, this rhizobium bacteria will be always living along with the leguminous plant roots. Okay, this bacteria always living in the root part of this leguminous plants. Leguminous plants means example the gram, peas, mung dal, beans plant. Okay, so these are all plants are having the two cotyledon like this. This is a seed means suppose it is a groundnut. Okay, so if you peel off this one, there will be two cotyledons. This two parts, two lobes we will get it. So we will call them as leguminous plants. Okay, so these plants in the root part, this bacteria is residing. Okay, this bacteria, what it will do? It will convert the nitrogen gas is there, no? That will be converted into ammonia. Who will do? This bacteria will do. Okay, that gaseous form will not be used by the plants directly. So they are depending on this bacteria for this conversion. Okay, and in other ways, rhizobium bacteria is there, no? It is living in the root part of the plant body. So it is getting the shelter also, and it is getting the food also. Required nutrients it will suck from the plant body. Okay, so in this way, rhizobium bacteria and this plant both are living together in a symbiotic relationship. Okay, so this bacteria is getting food and shelter from the plant body. Plant is getting ammonia or usable form of nitrogen, and it is mixed with the soil and it will be sucked by the plants and they will grow in a healthy way. Okay, so in this way both are benefited and they will come under the symbiotic relationship. Okay, so this relationship is there, no? This is helping very much for the farmers because they need not to add the extra fertilizer or manure to the plant. Okay, so in this way the nitrogen content will be replenished, few nutrients will be replenished in the soil by the activity of this like bacteria. Okay, if it is not present, they are adding the manure. Okay, in this way this bacteria is helping the farmers also. Got it? So this is the end of the lesson, children. So whole part of the lesson I finished. So I done this lesson very detailed way because you have to understand the concept, and whatever I wrote the diagrams or points on the board, now all this you have to take down and write down, children, because again and again this video is not repeated. So once it is written and erased means you will not get it again. One day it will be there, next day you will not get it, no? That's why I'm telling. And next week for they are sending you the assignment, so that I'm giving the assignments, three questions only I'm giving, that too from what I gave the points, no? From that, or you select from the textbook also if you have. Okay, so that questions you take down, I'm giving the assignment to you. What is nutrition? Second question, what are the modes of nutrition? Third, What is autotrophic? And heterotrophic nutrition. Fourth, what is photosynthesis? Okay, four questions. Okay, learn and write. Four question answers. One time. Understand? Only one time I give. You have to learn and write, children. Without learning, simply if you return, there is no use. Okay, so this will be, I have given here now. Again, they won't send you to through the online. That's why we return. This also you take down and do the homework in the homework book only. Homework you have to do in a single line notebook, that is 100 pages. And classwork you have to write in a 200 pages, one side unrolled book. Okay. So these points all you take down in a rough note. Okay, science rough note when you keep. Any old year old book also you can keep it and use as a science rough note. Okay. So today I finished lesson number 1. You go through all the pages of this lesson, okay, and we will send you the notes also. Okay, so with that you write very very neatly and draw the lines, children. After each question and answer you have to draw the lines, which day you are writing. Now that day, for date and day, topic, that means lesson number 1, nutrition in plants. Answer the following questions. Like that heading you write it, children, then you go for writing the question answers. Okay. Thank you one and all.